Thanks, Meg, and thanks to all of you for being here this afternoon. As Meg said, my name is Amy Moses. I am Vice President and Rhode Island Director at the Conservation Law Foundation. CLF is a member-supported environmental advocacy organization. We work throughout New England. When environmental laws are not being followed, we bring lawsuits to enforce them. And when environmental laws are not strong enough, we get better environmental laws passed. Conservation Law Foundation is focused on climate change because climate change is an emergency. We are working to combat climate change in courts, in state houses, and in government agencies. As Meg said, I'm here today on behalf of many, many members of Rhode Island environmental organizations. We are all here today to voice our opposition to Trump's plan to open up our oceans to offshore drilling for oil and gas. The Ocean State's environmental community is united against this reckless and irresponsible plan. As you've already heard this afternoon, we have way too much at stake to jeopardize the health of our oceans. Offshore oil and gas is a dirty and destructive business. From exploratory seismic testing, to drilling, to spilling. It's risky, it's harmful, and it's unnecessary. The fossil fuel era is over. Proposing offshore drilling for oil and gas is moving us backwards in a dangerous direction. Rhode Island is at risk from climate change, both above and below the surface of the water. We're already grappling with sea level rise, warming water, and increased ocean acidity. The last thing our ocean needs now is more disruption. CLF is also concerned about the critically endangered North Atlantic right whale. Its population is on the brink. Adding seismic testing, drilling, and pollution could really push the North Atlantic right whale over the edge. Instead of threatening the health of our oceans and its inhabitants, we should be looking forward and creating more clean, renewable energy. For many of us, we appreciate the ocean from the shore and from our beaches. We often just see the surface of the ocean. Trump's plan includes opening up areas of the ocean like Cassius Ledge and George's Bank. These are really totally amazing areas below the surface. I had the opportunity to be a volunteer on a NOAA research vessel years ago in the George's Bank area, and I saw firsthand the amazing life that lives below the surface. We must do everything we can to protect it. Now, Conservation Law Foundation has been fighting to block oil exploration in George's Bank since 1978. That's 40 years ago. Back in 1978, CLF was successful in winning a court injunction to block offshore drilling. We argued that oil leasing was inconsistent with federal fisheries law and that the risks and pollution from exploration and operation would be catastrophic to marine fish and shellfish. Today, especially with all of you here, the Conservation Law Foundation is grateful that so many people are outraged by Trump's plan. We applaud our entire congressional delegation and the numerous elected officials for their solidarity in opposing this dangerous proposal. All Rhode Islanders, especially you folks here, can file comments with the Federal Bureau of Ocean Energy Management. You can do that today at the Marriott until 7, or you can file comments online up until March 9th. Hopefully these comments will stop this reckless and irresponsible plan. But if that doesn't work, CLF is ready to fight it every step of the way, including going to court. Thanks again to all of you for joining us here today. It's not over yet. There are many more activities this afternoon. In a couple of minutes, we're all going to be marching here from the State House over to the Marriott. And once you get to the Marriott, there are three different ways you can voice your opposition to this plan. There will be a rally outside the Marriott, which I encourage everyone to participate in. Second, inside the federal government meeting at the Marriott, there is going to be a real, actual public hearing happening at 5 o'clock. And what I mean by that is the federal government is having a meeting with people at tables, but there is no way to speak up and speak out. There are no government officials there. So because the government has decided to set up that sort of faux public meeting, if you will, a number of environmental organizations have organized a real public hearing that's going to happen inside the federal government hearing, and that's at 5 o'clock. And in addition to the outside rally and the inside meeting, where you can actually speak up and have your voice heard, you can also file comments at the meeting with the government. So thanks, everyone, and I hope to see you at the Marriott.